I guess Wildberry Princess uses this chainsaw for carving up her meat. A little extreme, but probably pretty effective. I'll hang on to this in case I need to carve off a hunk of meat or something. Hello? Yo, food dude! Hello? It's a black marker. That marker will come in handy if I have to write or draw something. I guess it kind of makes sense that people made of fruit would prefer to eat meat. Good thing that shark's not alive. It'd really be attracted to Wildberry Princess's meat spa. Good thing that shark's not alive. It'd really be attracted to Wildberry Princess's meat spa. No way I could take the whole shark off that hook. I cut off the shark's fin. Now what? Table. This is probably where Wildberry Princess prepares her delicious meat treats. Looks like Wildberry Princess is relaxing in her meat spa. Meat spa, ugh. Sorry to interrupt your, bath, Wildberry Princess, but I need to talk to you.
Oh, that's okay, Marceline. I've just been meditating, trying to figure out what to do about all the problems in Wildberry Kingdom. Maybe you can help.
Maybe, but I'm gonna need to ask you a few questions. So, gotta ask, why do you take meat baths? Some kind of medical condition? Like how your berries fly off when you're scared?
Yes, exactly. My berries are petrified. With all the stress lately, they're as hard as cannonballs instead of being soft and juicy. If they were to fly off and hit someone now, it would be very painful. I'm hoping the meat bath will soften them up. Eventually. No luck so far.
That's a nice shark you've got over there. I didn't know you liked to eat seafood.
I don't. That shark scared me when I was swimming in the ocean a while ago. So I had it executed. I hate sharks. Nothing scares me more than sharks.
That magic artifact you bought at my yard sale might have some dangerous side effects. Have you noticed anything strange?
Yes! I bought the Feed Bucket of Plenty because it makes our animal herds regenerate after we harvest their tasty, succulent meat. But the magical meat, changes people that eat it.
Exactly how does the meat change people?
You know how they say, you are what you eat? Well, that's what's happening. Those things in the cage over there, they're my people. When they eat the magic meat, they change into weird fruit-animal hybrids. After that, they stop thinking for themselves. We call them food boys. They just do whatever other people tell them to do. It's really weird and unsettling.
Where's the Feed Bucket of Plenty now? You're not still using it, are you? If there are problems in your kingdom, why didn't you ask for help? I'm sure Finn and Jake would have been happy to...
I don't want to talk about Finn and Jake! I'm still mad at them!
How come? I thought they apologized for the whole money thing.
Yes, they wrote a nicely worded letter of apology. I'm guessing Bimo helped because the spelling was impeccable. But all of that money they left behind has gone to my people's heads. They just sit around all day and expect people to wait on them hand and foot. Nothing is getting done. If I don't find a solution soon, Wildberry Kingdom is doomed.
Wildberry Princess, I need to lock that artifact up in Billy's cave where it won't cause any more trouble. Can I have it?
Yes, but you have to help me first. We captured a lot of the food boys. But there are still some out there. I had my 3 most reliable Wildberry citizens on capture duty, but even they have gotten fat and lazy. They've got huge piles of Finn and Jake's money and food boys to feed them night and day. If you can lure the rest of the food boys into the capture cages, I can lock them up. Then, with nobody left to wait on them, my citizens will finally go back to work. Please, Marceline, if you help me fix this, I'll give you the artifact. What do you say?
Yeah, sure. I'll help. Where do I start?
The remaining food boys are in the kingdom down below. Just head straight down from the balcony. You can't miss them. I'll just decompress here in my meat spa until you're done. Thanks, Marceline.
Those used to be Wildberry people?
Freaky.
You would think they'd stop eating the magic meat when they saw what was happening to them. Those used to be Wildberry people?
Freaky.
Well, didn't take long to find the first food, dude. Looks like he's using that plant cannon thing to shoot steaks. Into that guy's mouth. Ugh. Wildberry Princess was right. Her peeps have gotten super lazy. And that's the cage that the lazy Wildberry guy was supposed to herd the food boy into. I'm gonna have to figure out a way to get him in there. That's doing absolutely nothing. Yuck! Ugh, some old food scraps. Yuck! Ugh, some old food scraps. Maybe I can dump these food scraps in a compost bin or something. It's a bare patch of dirt. Looks like somebody was going to plant something there. Looks like that plant works like some kind of gun. It eats anything that gets put in front of it, then blasts it out like a cannonball. I can't move that plant by hand. I'd have to dig it up first. It looks like this food dude will just stand there shooting steaks out of that plant all day unless I do something. Nothing. Guess as long as he's feeding somebody, he doesn't even notice me. It seems like the only thing these guys do is feed super lazy fat people. Not exactly a fulfilling existence. No point in talking to these guys. They only understand food and fear. That is not working. That's right. Run to the plant, get swallowed, and darn! Guess I should have known that he'd just hit that stone slab. Gonna have to fix that. It's a pile of that meat that the food boys are feeding to the Wildberry people. Looks kinda tasty. Might as well take this. Wildberry Princess is always interested in delicious meat products. Another one of those shooter plants. It's pointed at the cage, but that stone slab and hedge are blocking it. Yeah. I don't think so. Look at all this gold! Wildberry Kingdom sure isn't hurting for Dosh. I wonder how much of this gold used to belong to Finn and Jake. Those guys do not know how to manage money. I really don't need more gold. I've got tons of it back at Billy's cave. Look at all this gold! Wildberry Kingdom sure isn't hurting for Dosh. I wonder how much of this gold used to belong to Finn and Jake. Those guys do not know how to manage money. That's a pretty nice shovel. That's a pretty nice shovel. Shovel? Yeah, I can dig it. That's the cage they set up to catch the food boy. That won't work. I have to find a way to get the food boy inside there without moving the cage. Not too surprising to see a pair of hedge clippers here. There are a lot of hedges around. Ah, sure, why not? You never know when I might get the urge to trim a hedge. A sign with a tasty-looking red arrow on it. I can't move or turn the sign. It's there to stay. Yum. Now the sign is blank. Not bad. Now the arrow is pointing towards the shooter plant. The arrow I drew on the sign points toward the shooter plant. Look at all this gold! Wildberry Kingdom sure isn't hurting for Dosh. I wonder how much of this gold used to belong to Finn and Jake. Those guys do not know how to manage money. Loosened up the dirt. There was some really fertile soil under the hard stuff. I'm gonna keep a little of that dirt for later, just in case. Yeah, mixing those food scraps into the fertile soil made some really excellent compost. Okay, I have a big cannon plant thing, and looks like the food boy can't figure out what to do now. Yeah, I think that shooter plant thing will grow just fine here. Looks like it's ready to start shooting stuff already. The plant looks happy there. No way that Wildberry guy is getting any steaks now, though. The plant's pointed right at the stone slab. I already replanted it once. No sense in moving it again.
I'll give you the artifact as soon as you round up the rest of the food boys.
Hey, Wildberry Princess. I found some delicious meats while I was out dealing with the food boys. You interested?
Oh, yes! Even in the midst of a crisis, I am inexplicably distracted by delicious meat products.
Nice! It looks like a shark is swimming in the meat spa. If that doesn't help me scare Wildberry Princess, nothing will.
I've been working on my fear management. Not much scares me anymore.
Huh? Oh, no. I wasn't trying to scare you. I was trying to scare that shark that's swimming in your meat spa.
What are you talking about? That's impossible!
Finn and Jake were right. That is kind of funny. Wildberry Princess is petrified berries. I kind of feel bad about scaring them off of her, but oh well. These berries are as hard as cannonballs. I can totally find a use for these. I'm thinking she's probably a little mad at me right now. I better let her cool off for a while.
You know, if you needed petrified berries, I could have
no more stone slab. Now there's a clear shot to the cage. Smash! So much for the stone slab. The slab is gone, but that hedge is still blocking the way to the cage. The slab is gone, but that hedge is still blocking the way to the cage. I'm not touching that. It looks like it has thorns. Well, now I've cut a hole in the hedge. Hope Wildberry Princess doesn't mind. Yeah, that's disgusting. No point in talking to these guys. They only understand food and fear. Okay, let's get this guy in his cage. Off you go. Into the plant and into the cage. Good riddance. Look at all this gold! Wildberry Kingdom sure isn't hurting for Dosh. I wonder how much of this gold used to belong to Finn and Jake. Those guys do not know how to manage money. I've got better things to do than steal gold. I really don't need more gold. I've got tons of it back at Billy's cave. It's another one of those shooter plant things. It's pointed at the cage, but this one's just a seedling. It's not big enough to shoot stuff yet. I don't think yanking on the little plant is gonna make it grow. Wow, these things grow fast. Well, now that it's adult-sized, I guess it's fully functional. Now that I took away his cannon plant, I guess he's just gonna stand there and do nothing. I'm guessing I still can't talk you into going to the cage? Yeah, no. Okay, let's try this now. There he goes! Right into the plant, and boom! 2 points. Yeah, that's disgusting. Off he goes. Down to the sign. Turn at the arrow. Yes, that's one less food boy to worry about. All right, Wildberry Princess. I just captured the last of the food boys. Problem solved. Now, if I can just get that artifact...
Sure, no problem. To get rid of it. Here!
Yeah, thanks. Hey, I'm really sorry about scaring off your berries like that. I feel kind of bad about it.
Oh, don't worry about it. The hospital can reattach them. If I can find all of them, that is. I'm just glad you were able to round up all of my altered Wildberry subjects.
About that. I checked. There's no way to change them back. Guess they can still live fulfilling lives as servants, though. They're really good at that.
Yeah, but my people have proven that they become lazy when waited upon, so they can't stay here. Luckily, I heard that a king out in the forest is looking for some servants to work in his underground kingdom. I think my altered subjects will be happy, or at least busy, there.
Sure, okay. Guess I'll be going then. Good luck finding your berries.
Thanks! Bye, Marceline!
Hello? Is it me, or did this place get super weird since last time we were here?
Marceline! Oh, glad you came back! I thought I was a goner!
Yo, Peppermint Butler! Are you in here?
Right here!
Told you this guy was bad news.
Ah, there you are. I take it you found the final artifact?
Yeah. Got it right here.
Good. You've done very well. Very well indeed.
Peppermint Butler, what are...
No time for chit-chat. Everything's almost ready. Oh, silly me. I almost forgot. I'll be right back.
Huh? About those two other artifacts you're holding for me?
Yes. They're on the stands over there. Once the third artifact is released, they'll be automatically placed in the, containment thing.
Huh. Hey, yeah, that's convenient. I can carry all three at the same time in this. Thanks for your help! Later, Peppermint Butler!
What was that, Marceline? I... Oh.
Get us, please! Let's go home now!
All the doors have been changed.
Yeah, they've got lights over them. And there's a bunch of poles with lemons on them in the hall.
That must be the security system Lemongrab was talking about. Wonder how it works.
He said it was really complicated. Sure hope we can figure it out. If we don't, we'll never get that catcher's mitt.
This lemon pole has a dark-colored lemon on it. Looks like it's dirty or something.
A pole with a dark lemon on it. It's like it's got some black gunk on it. Probably clean that off pretty easy.
This lemon pole has a dark-colored lemon on it. Looks like it's dirty or something. That lemon is way too dirty to clean off with my hand.
You're gonna need some water or something to clean the gunk off that lemon.
This lemon pole has a light-colored lemon on it.
The lemon on that pole is light-colored. Bet we could make it look like the dark ones if we got it dirty somehow. I don't think that's gonna make the lemon on the pole change color.
There! Now it looks like the dark-colored lemon pulls. All clean! Now it's a light-colored lemon pull. There's the catcher's mitt. If I call the sword, maybe it'll land in the mitt. Worth a try, I guess. All right, guess I'll try calling the sword. Here goes no tongue!
The catcher's mitt must be a lot bouncier than the gauntlet of the hero. We're gonna have to find some way to make the sword stick to the mitt. The sword hits the mitt when you call it, but it bounces right off. Gonna have to find a way to make it stick.
There! Now it looks like the dark-colored lemon pulls. All clean! Now it's a light-colored lemon pull.
Yeah, that'll work. Now that one looks just like the dark-colored lemon pulls.
All clean! Now it's a light-colored lemon pull. Lemon John candies. These things are so sour that only lemon grab and his lemon peeps can eat them.
Those Lemon John candies are super sour. I bet they're Lemon Grab's favorite treat. He's got weird taste. Nice work, Finn. Now that lemon pole is light covered.
There! Now it looks like the dark colored lemon poles.
Nice thought, but the lemon candy isn't sticky enough to stop the sore. Maybe if it was chewed up, but it's way too sour for us to chew.
I bet he totally eats some of that sour Lemon John candy we found.
You should give him some of those Lemon John candies we found. Not like we could ever eat them.
You are wasting time! If you do not get past my lemon defenses, you will not find the mitt you seek! The time to talk is over! Challenge my security system and get to the catcher's mitt! Or leave now and do not return!
I bet he totally eats some of that sour Lemon John candy we found.
You should give him some of those Lemon John candies we found. Not like we could ever eat them.
Hey, Lemon Grab, we found a bunch of lemon candy. Want some?
Yes! I love lemon candy! Yes, so sour. Sour is so much better than spicy. Spicy is unacceptable.
Hey, what do you think about one more prank for old time's sake? Maybe spice things up a little.
Yeah, I bet we can come up with something good.
Lemon Grab will totally flip if we give him some spicy Lemon John candies.
Hey, we still got plenty lemon candy left. Want some more?
Yes! Sour, non-spicy lemon candy is my favorite of all treats!
This is gonna be great!
Wonderful! This is... spicy! Too spicy! You have spice pranked me again! I will not stand for this! It is unacceptable! I am in need of water! I am going! Do not try to follow me and console me in any way!
Yeah, no worries on that front.
Mathematical! Sweet! Lemon Grab spat out that spicy Lemon John wad right onto the floor. Kinda gross.
It's that wad of spicy lemon candy Lemon Grab spit out. Gross. Sticky.
That's really sticky.
Good thinking. The sword won't bounce off the mitt now.
Okay, let me try calling the sword again. No tongue!
Hey, it worked. Let's grab that stupid sword and get out of here.
All right.
Cool.
Come on, Finn. Just take the sword so we can head back to Billy's cave. Finn, after all that, you're gonna leave without taking the sword? No point in comparing swords, Finn. Billy's is way more awesome. Glad that's over. Let's head back to Billy's cave and put that sword where it belongs.
Finn, Jake, you're back. Did you get Billy's sword?
Yeah, but you wouldn't believe what we had to go through to get it.
Nah, I was filling Marceline in on what yous did. Glad it all turned out. And no hard feelings for taking all my peppers. We can even that score at some later date.
Thanks. Marceline, how about you? Any problems tracking down all the artifacts and putting them back in Billy's cave?
No problems worth mentioning. Everything's back. We should be fine once we seal up the cave.
Then what are we waiting for? I guess nothing. Hey, where are you going? Man, that is super annoying.
Yeah, and it's gonna be a problem. The cave won't stay sealed if the sword keeps flying away to its owner.
What can we do? I wish there was a way to make Billy the rightful owner again.
That's it! Good thinking! If you destroy the bill of sale, the sword reverts to its original owner.
Great! Let's do it! Glad Flambeau's not holding a grudge about us taking his peppers.
Flambeau's still looking particularly fiery. Glad taking his peppers didn't cool him off or anything.
Maybe you should think about getting me some more peppers when we're all done here. You's figure out a way to destroy that bill of sale thing yet?
Sure glad Marceline was able to get back all of Billy's artifacts.
Marceline looks like she's ready to leave. We should burn the bill of sale so we can close Billy's cave.
You figure out how to destroy the bill of sale yet? Just destroy the bill of sale so we can close Billy's cave. I got stuff to do. No way! I don't want to own that crazy sword. No, Finn, you have to destroy the bill of sale, not give it to me.
That's the crack that Billy's sword goes in.
Once that bill of sale is destroyed, we could put the sword in that crack and lock those dangerous artifacts in Billy's cave.
I think I've seen this snail before. An old fire pit.
Fire pit. That's a perfect place to burn something.
An old fire pit.
Fire pit. That's a perfect place to burn something.
The bill of sale is ready to burn. Now we have to find a way to get it burning. The bill of sale is in the fire pit. Now I need some stuff to burn and a way to light it. The bill of sale is in the fire pit. Now I need some stuff to burn and a way to light it. I don't think so.
Now all we have to do is find a way to light the fire.
Hey, Flambeau! Want the rest of your peppers back?
Oh, there's some left? Yeah, sure. Yours are great.
All right. Bye-bye, bill of sale.
Yeah! Now let's seal up Billy's cave so we can head home. Glad Flambeau's not holding a grudge about us taking his peppers. That's the crack where we first saw No Tongue.
You remember how to close Billy's cave, right? Just use No Tongue.
I think Marceline wants us to close Billy's cave so she can leave.
She's looking a little impatient, Finn. Let's just close the cave so we can all leave.
You guys gonna finish this thing up or what? I haven't got all day. Just close Billy's cave so we can go home, Finn.
Okay, time to close up Billy's cave again. Ugh.
Now all of Billy's stuff is safely locked away where nobody will get to it. At least for now.
Thanks, guys. Sorry I caused so much trouble.
It's okay. Just no more yard sales!
Are you guys telling me what I can and can't do?
No. Marceline, you can totally do whatever you want. We would never...
Oh, after all these years, you guys are still easy targets. See ya!
Sheesh! I think I've had enough for today. Let's head home.
You said it, buddy. I could use a little downtime. This investigation stuff is hard work.
Perfect! That's exactly what Bimo needed. There! Finn! Jake! I have fixed the record player! Yay, Bimo!
Whoa! Nice job, Bimo! That's even better than the old one!
Yeah, that's awesome! What say we do a little dancing to celebrate our first four successful investigations?
That's a great idea! I think we should start by playing my favorite record, the one Mom and Dad used to play for me. Where'd you put it, Bimo?
I have it right here, Finn. Don't worry, I kept it very safe, and I cleaned it up just for you!
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's spin that puppy!
Here we go! Yay! Thanks, Patty!
There is actually music on your favorite record, right?
Bimo, when you cleaned the record, what did you do?
I noticed that the record was very bumpy, so I fixed it with sandpaper. It's now smooth as a Bimo's bottom. Yay, Bimo!
You did what?
Bimo, the bumpy parts are what hold all the music and stuff. Without those, the record won't play.
Oh no, Bimo has really messed things up. I'm sorry, Finn.
That's okay, Bimo. You were only trying to help. But man, what are we gonna do, Jake? That record was a reminder of how Mom and Dad raised me after they found me in the woods. I love that record.
Don't worry, buddy. We'll think of some...
Jake, I don't know if I can concentrate on another case right now.
I don't know, man. Check this out.
Investigators desperate to fix Finn's favorite record. That's weirdly specific.
Yeah, but it must mean there's a way to fix the record. What should we do first?
Well, let's start by taking the record to Marceline. She helped us the last time we had a musical problem. Maybe she knows what we have to do to fix it. Look, there's a new case available on the ticker site.
Back from the fire, Kingdom. What a mess that was. Now, where was I? Oh, yeah, PD's latest plot. Finn and Jake investigations. Now, those two have solved some cases for sure, but they've made some folks mighty angry. Anonymous caller who says he's very unhappy with Finn and Jake investigations and has taken one of Finn's favorites. From the Fire Kingdom. What a mess that was. Now, where was I? Oh, yeah. PD's latest plot. Finn and Jake investigations. Now, those two have solved some cases for sure, but they've made some folks mighty angry. Anonymous caller who says he's very unhappy with Finn and Jake investigations and has taken one of Finn's favorites.
Kingdom again soon. On second thought, maybe not.
We are rolling in it, dude!
Whoa! We're gonna have to go to Wildberry Kingdom again soon. On second thought, maybe not.
We are rolling in it, dude!